गुड मॉर्निंग, मैं प्रशांत गहलोत एंशंट इंडिया प्राचीन भारत के इस यूट्यूब चैनल में आपका स्वागत करता हूं। आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है कैटफिश फार्मिंग डिटेल्स। विजन 2020 एंशंट इंडिया प्राचीन भारत लो इन्वेस्टमेंट बिजनेस आइडियाज एंड सिक्योर योर इन्वेस्टमेंट ट्रेनिंग एंड नॉलेज पार्टनर कंसल्टेंट एंड बिजनेस प्लानर एंड पार्टनर फ्री अवेयरनेस कैंपेन एंड एजुकेशनल सीरीज फॉर फिश एंड श्रिम्प फार्मिंग एंड मच मोर एडवाइस तो ज़रूरी है, वी आर बिल्डिंग द ट्रस्ट। आज का जो हमारा वीडियो फॉल करेगा सीरीज 2 फिश फार्मिंग इन सीमेंटेड पॉन्ड। क्लेरियस स्पीशीज आर नॉर्मली फाउंड इन फ्रेश वाटर एंड ब्रैकिश वाटर विद लोअर डिजॉल्व ऑक्सीजन। दे हैव द एबिलिटी टू ग्रो इवन इन पुअर एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशन। दे आर रेयर्ड अप टू मार्केट साइज इन अर्दन पॉन्ड वेयर एज द ईस्टर्न इंडिया इट इज़ अ ग्रोन इन पार्शली इम्प्रूव्ड स्वैम्प। क्लेरियस बैक्टेरियस नॉर्मली कॉल्ड एज मांगूर इन इंडिया हैज ग्रेटर वैल्यू एंड हाई डिमांड इन इंडिया ड्यू टू इट्स एप्टिट्यूड वैल्यू। तो जो हमारी क्लेरियस फैमिली की फिशेज हैं जनरली फ्रेश वाटर में और आपका ब्रैकिश वाटर में दोनों में सर्वाइव करता है और लोअर डिजॉल्व ऑक्सीजन में भी ये सर्वाइव करती है। इतना अच्छा वाटर कंडीशन नहीं होगा बट दे विल सर्वाइव एंड गेट अ गुड प्राइस इन द मार्केट। ब्रॉड स्टॉक मेंटेनेंस अ हेल्दी ब्रॉड स्टॉक इज एसेंशियल स्पेशली इन कैप्टिव कंडीशन टू प्रोड्यूस अ हेल्दी फ्राई एंड अटेन अ ग्रेटर सर्वाइवल रेट। द क्लेरियस बैक्टेरियस अटेन मैच्योरिटी इन द फर्स्ट ईयर। द ब्रॉड फिशेज आर रियर्ड इन एन अर्दन पॉन्ड विद अ स्टॉकिंग डेंसिटी ऑफ 2 to 3 पर मीट्रिक क्यूब। बिफोर 2-3 मंथ्स टू द स्पॉनिंग सीजन द ब्रॉड फिशेज आर ट्रांसफर टू सॉयल बेस्ड जहाँ पर 2 to 3 सेंटीमीटर का सीमेंटेड टैंक में आपका सॉयल होगा फॉर कंडीशनिंग। इन कमर्शियल हैचरी द ब्रॉड फिशेज आर स्टॉक इन हापा इन द सेम पॉन्ड फॉर कंडीशनिंग। द ब्रॉड फिशेज आर फेड विद अ मिक्स ऑफ ग्राउंडनट ऑयल केक एंड राइस ब्रैन एट अबाउट 3 to 5% ऑफ बॉडी वेट ऑफ फिश। फॉर बेटर ब्रीडिंग परफॉर्मेंस फिशेज आर फेड विद द मिक्सचर ऑफ ग्राउंडनट ऑयल केक सोयाबीन मील राइस ब्रैन विटामिन एंड मिनरल मिक्सचर एट 32% ऑफ वाटर इज एक्सचेंज टू मेंटेन गुड वाटर क्वालिटी इन द कल्चर सिस्टम। एडिशनली इन ब्रीडिंग शुड बी अवॉइडेड बिकॉज इट रिड्यूस द सर्वाइवल ग्रोथ रेट एंड इंक्रीजेज द डिफॉर्मिटी ऑफ फ्राई। इट कैन बी बाई एक्सचेंजिंग ब्रॉड फिश बिटवीन द फार्मर्स और एडिंग द ब्रॉड फिश फ्रॉम द नेचुरल एनवायरमेंट। The sexes can be identified through secondary sexual characteristics. The female has the round and bulging abdomen with pinkish bottom shaped anal papilla. The male has a pointed anal papilla. Mangur normally breeds during June to August. The broad fishes above 100 gram is preferable but 100 to 150 gram is recommended for better breeding performance. A female broadfish of 150 gram size can be expected to spawn 5,000 to 6,000 eggs. Artificial propagation. The spawning can successfully be done by artificial propagation method. The synthetic hormones such as the ovaprene, ovatide, VOFH and cap preparatory extract are used to induce the female mangur. Except carp putridity extract, other synthetic hormones are used at about 1 to 1.5 ml per kg. The carp putridity gland extract is used at the rate of 30 to 40 mg per kg body weight of fish. Usually no injection is given for male brooder because they don't the sperm elevate. However, the synthetic hormone 8.5 mg per kg of fish is injected to male broodfish to obtain better egg quality. The female is striped after 17 hours of injection to get the egg. The male fishes do not respond and males are sacrificed to collect the testes. Hence the sperm solution, saline solution, 0.9% of sodium chloride is prepared by using male creamy white testes to get the sperm suspension. The eggs are collected in plastic tray and fertilized with sperm suspension by using feather. a little amount of water is added to activate the eggs. After mixing for 2-3 minutes, eggs are washed in running water and it is transferred into incubation plastic container. Flow through hatchery system is adopted for fry production of magur. The plastic container kept under the tap and has an outlet provision at the height of 4 to 5 cm. Generally 1000 to 1500 fertilized eggs are washed in running water and it is transferred into incubation plastic container. And feedable water flow is provided to maintain the optimum oxygen level for hatching. It takes about 24 to 27 hours at 27 to 30 degrees centigrade. A newly hatched larva measures 4 to 6 mm length and 2.3 mg weight. Fry rearing tank preparation. A small cement tank size of 10 to 20 meter square is recommended for better management. The bottom of the tank is to be filled with about 2 to 3 cm soil and the water level is to be 0.25 to 0.30 meter. The fertilizer 100 gram single superphosphate and 2 kg cow dung are provided for nourishment of plankton growth. The tank have to be prepared about a week before stocking of fry. Feeding. A newly hatched larva consumes the yolk sac up to 3 dps, day of post-hatching. After yolk sac absorption, the larvae are fed with mixed zooplankton such as the copepods, Daphnia, Artemia, Tubifex, Castrex, etc. After 8 days, the larvae are fed with Tartar M, a product of CIFA, to obtain better survival and growth. Or you can use your homemade feed as per the requirement. Stocking density and others. The recommended stocking density is about 1000 to 1500 per meter square. Regular cleaning of uneaten feed and debris, adequate supply of aeration and water management have to be taken care. It is advised to replenish 50 to 60% of water twice daily. Aerial respiration commences after 10 to 11 days. Larva growth measures about 10 to 20 mm length, 30 to 40 mg weight during 15 to 20 days of rearing. Fingerling rearing. The better growth and survival are obtained with fry stocking size of 1 gram 40 to 45 days with a density of 15 to 100 meter square in fingerling production. Feeding has to be adjusted according to the weight of the fish couple of times in a month. The fry is fed twice a day at 6 to 8% of body weight with 30 to 30% of protein. Shooting behavior is normally found at this stage. To avoid this, the larger size fish has to be segregated at regular interval to get the enhanced survival rate. It reaches about 4 to 5 gram during 60 to 70 days. Grow out culture pond preparation. For grow out of C. bacteris, a small pond of size 0.02 to 0.1 hectare is preferred. The water depth is to be maintained at 0.5 to 1 meter. The pond should have a suitable slope of 1:2 or 1:3 and height of the dike should be above 100 cm from the water level. C. bacteris move from one pond to another pond, especially during the rainy season. So the pond has to be constructed in such a way to prevent this migration. The pond is prepared similar to carp grow out pond. The unwanted for predatory fishes and their eggs are irradiated by sink the mahua oil cake or bleaching powder. The agriculture lime at 200 to 250 kg is added when the soil pH is above 6. Stocking density. Commercially, most of the farmers stock about 200 fingerlings per meter square. Although the recommended stocking density rate is less than half of it, 50 to 70 meter square. Feeding. An improved growth and survival is obtained with a 6 of 3 to 5 gram of mangur. Feeding is adjusted according to the weight of the fish twice in a month. Fish meal based compound feed with 30 to 32% is preferred for C. bacteris. The fingerling are fed with 2 ration at 3 to 5% of body weight. It attain marketable size about 100 to 150 gram in 10 to 12 months. Harvest is done by hand picking method after complete dewatering of the pond. An average production is 2 to 3 tons per hectare in 10 to 12 months, or you can increase as per your management. Health management: mortality due to the bacterial and fungal pathogen are often associated with environmental stress. The CFEX, potassium permanganate and oxytetracycline are used to manage the infection. This is our team. Please like, share and subscribe. Also press the bell icon so that you can get the latest update for our upcoming videos. अगर आप हमारे टेलीग्राम ग्रुप और व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप से जुड़ना चाहते हैं तो आप हमें मैसेज करें 9971155753. थैंक यू.